This is going to be the second video about solving word problems with Venn diagrams. So here's the problem. In a group of 40 students, 22 are taking algebra, 18 are taking biology, 14 are taking chemistry, 9 are taking algebra and biology, 7 are taking algebra and chemistry, 5 are taking biology and chemistry, and 2 are taking all three courses. How many students are not taking any of these courses? Okay, so there's a lot of information. Let's copy the information down. I'm told there are 40 students, so that means my universal set is going to contain 40 elements. So the size of the universal set is 40. There are 22 students taking algebra, so we'll use an A for the set of students in algebra. And the size of that set is 22. 18 are taking biology, so the size of what we'll call set B is 18. 14 are taking chemistry, so that's going to be set C. And that has 14 students. Okay, now we've got some intersections. We've got 7 students taking algebra and chemistry. So that's the intersection of sets A and C. I'm sorry, I skipped one. 9 students are taking algebra and biology. So that's the intersection of set A and B. So the size of that intersection of A intersect B is 9. Then I've got 7 taking algebra and chemistry. So the size of the intersection of A and C is 7. What else do I have? 5 are taking biology and chemistry. So the size of that intersection is biology and chemistry is 5. And then 2 are taking all three courses. So that would be the intersection of A and B, as well as the intersection of that with C. So here's the intersection of A and B, A intersect B, and we're going to intersect that with C. And there are 2 students in there. Okay, so let's draw our rectangle for the universal set and start filling this in. Okay, so let's see what we have. I'm going to have 3 circles, one for set A, one for set B, and one for set C. They all overlap. And usually the easiest thing to do is let's start with the smallest area. Well, the smallest area we have is that intersection of A and B and C. And we know there are 2 students in there. And now, here's what we're going to do from here. I've got an intersection of A and B. Well, the intersection of A and B is supposed to contain 9 students, but 2 of those students are already accounted for. They're in the place where all 3 sets overlap. So that means I've got 7 more students who are going to fit in that intersection. I'll do the same thing for A and C. My intersection of A and C has 7 students in it, but I've already accounted for 2 of them in that little triangle in the middle. So that means I've got 5 more students over there. For my intersection of B and C, I've got 5 students. 2 of them are accounted for. So that means there are 3 students there. And now I can find out how many students are taking only algebra. So let's see. There's a total of 22 students in all who are taking algebra. And I want to subtract the ones I've already accounted for. So that's 7 plus 2 is 9, plus 5 is 14. And I want to subtract that from 22, and that's going to give me 8. Then I've got a total of 18 students who are taking biology. And I've already accounted for, 7 and 3 is 10, and 2 is 12. So I've accounted for 12 of them. There's 18 altogether. So there's 6 left who are taking only biology. In the chemistry set, there are a total of 14 students. I've got 5 plus 2 plus 3 accounted for. That's 10. So that means there are 4 students left who are taking only chemistry. And I've also got the fact that the universal set contains 20 students. I'm sorry, contains 40 students. And my question was, how many students are not taking any of these courses? So all I have to do is add up the total number of students that I have who are in any of these courses, algebra, biology, or chemistry, and subtract that from the universal set, which is 40. So let's see. I've got 8 plus 7 is 15, plus 5 is 20, plus 2 more is 22, plus 6 over here is 28, plus 3 is 31, and 4 more would be 35. So there were 35 students who are taking algebra or biology or chemistry or some combination of them. I've got 40 students in my universal set, so that means there will be 5 students left who are not taking algebra or biology or chemistry. Okay, so a bit of work, but mostly it's a matter of getting yourself set up, getting all your facts straight, entering the facts you know, and then using what's basically just arithmetic to get the remaining facts. Okay, so that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.